Well, the reality is that people eat for a lot of reasons. Most of the time, if you ask somebody why they're eating, they're going to tell you because of hunger. But if you start to list all the reasons we eat because of stress, we eat because it's time of the day, we eat because of social occasions. You rarely get together with a group of friends and you walk into their house and they say you want to go for a walk. They say, do you want a beverage? Do you want something to eat? So we eat for all these reasons, and one of the reasons is pleasure and taste. And when we're offered foods that are really, really tasty to us, or even in animal studies we've done, you know, rats like cake frosting as well, and rats will open up a Oreo cookie and lick out the middle. So, you know, we, as animals, we enjoy that sweet fat combination. And so those are brought into the holiday season in a tremendous way. Right, it's a type of the food, it's the time of the year, it's the social occasions, and we use food as a nurturing material. I mean, everybody knows that they like to feed somebody. It feels good when somebody comes and visits and you give them food. They feel good about that. So it's the season as well as the type of food. Well, one could use foods that are less concentrated in calories. So the we tend to eat for volume, amount that's sent in front of us. And if you use something with a lot of water and air in it, it has fewer calories because water and air don't have any calories. So if you were to put fruits and vegetables out instead of cookies, you would be helping people in that way. And offering both is another way of dealing with it, where you have fruits as well as some sweet treats that are traditional for the holidays. I think that one of the things you have to do is really think about what you're eating. You can't just eat automatically. So when somebody puts all this food in front of you, one of the dangers is variety, smorgasbord kind of a setup. You go over to somebody's house and they have 20 different things on the table. So one thing that would be helpful is to have less variety so that people, there's something called sensory specific satiety that's an interesting area. If you eat a lot of sugar, after a while you get tired of it and you go for the pretzels. Then when you get the pretzels, you get tired of it, go back to the sugar. And so if you have enough variety and if you have a smorgasbord set up, like I won't mention any particular restaurants, but those that have a whole variety of foods available, if you take a little bit of everything, you're in trouble because it adds up to a whole lot. So I would say presenting less food, using smaller plates, having less variety is probably one way of helping others. But most people won't want to do that. I mean, there's a lot of work that's been done with humans in terms of looking at portion size and finding out. There's studies that have been done. If you give people a lot more food, guess what? They eat a lot more food. If you give somebody a big bucket of popcorn versus a small bucket, they may want more after the small bucket, but after the big one, you know, they're eating a lot more calories than they need to. So portion control is a very important part, and that's been shown repeatedly with people. Modifying the behavior of an individual in terms of not having food at every time of the day, but trying to regulate it a little bit more, not having food for meetings and things of that sort. So there's been a fair amount of work in that way. We've studied various drugs over the years that might be useful or not so useful for weight control. The best drugs that have ever come out, you don't lose any more than 10% of your body weight anyway. But if you're 300 pounds and you lose 30 pounds, it does help you in terms of health. Thank you.